Welcome back from aluminum to steel. The JSW steel stock is at a 52-week high. It's up three times from its April 2020 lows. Of course, that was an unusual low. Steel demand and prices have been on a strong footing. Nigel has been reporting the rise in steel prices. Seshagiri Rao, Joint Managing Director and Group CFO of JSW Steel, joins us now. Good morning, Mr. Rao. Thank you very much. I guess you are the encyclopedia and the final word on steel demand and prices. Can you size it up for us? Do you think that, I mean, is there a shortage now? Are you all not able to produce to capacity? What are the volumes and how do you see prices going?
Production is improving that way, both in India and also globally. If I look at the production numbers globally for the month of November, it was 162 million tons, which is a 7% growth year-on-year basis. So production is improving. And even in India, the production improved if I compare with the month of April. So there is an improvement in production, but the two themes which are very relevant now for the steel industry is that the steel restocking cycle started. During the COVID period, all the inventories either at the service centers or with the customers or with the steel companies got exhausted. So this restocking cycle which started led to shortage of steel across the globe. Today steel is not available, notwithstanding the production improvement. This is one reason. The second one is uneven increase in production. If you look at China, the production increase was over 13%. Whereas that is not the growth in production other than China, rest of the world, if I see. The production has not improved that much. So production improved on an absolute number basis worldwide and also in India, but it is not even. So that is also causing shortages across the world. The second reason is the iron ore prices. Iron ore prices went up as low as $83-$84, which we have seen. Today, $137-$138. So iron ore shortage is also one of the reasons why the production is not able to keep pace with the improvement in demand. There are the two main reasons which I am seeing a very strong recovery in steel prices and also a good good demand recovery we are observing in the marketplace. Okay. If I look at as far as India is concerned, one important thing here is production is not improved so much. If I see year-on-year basis, crude steel production just 0.2% in the month of October, in the month of November. So production improvement is not very substantial if I compare globally. The reason for this is iron ore shortage. Iron ore shortage, production shortage was substantial. There are 37 million ton lower production on year-on-year basis in India. Over and above that, there is a huge increase in the exports. 37 million tons of iron ore has been exported from India, causing a lot of shortage in the iron ore production. That is why the steel production has not kept pace with the recovery in the demand. These are the reasons which I am seeing a big issue as far as India is concerned to improve the production.
Okay. Can you confirm how much price rise you took in December? Also, in terms of output for this quarter, we are almost two-thirds over. What was your output vis-a-vis last year, October, November?
We already announced our production numbers for the month of October. So as far as November is concerned, I think in the next few days, we will come out with our numbers. But the overall year-on-year, there is definitely a growth in production. But this production could have been much better, and the utilization could have been better if iron ore supplies are not disrupted. Even in Karnataka, the Donimalai mine has not started. So it is also causing a shortage of iron ore across the regions. Therefore, there is an improvement year-on-year. But the production guidance which we have given of 16 million ton, it appears to be tough to reach that because of shortage of iron ore in India.
And the price hike?
We have taken a hike of 2,500 rupees per ton in the month of December.
Okay. Just to, go further on that, Mr. Rao, so I believe that, current hot rolled coal prices would be around, 13,000 thereabouts? And given the factors that you just described, are you expecting more upside in the coming few weeks and months?
The steel industry is very difficult to say what happens to the prices. But one important thing here is in India, in the month of June, the iron ore prices used to be 1960 rupees. whereas today it is 4,160 rupees, more than 100% increase in domestic iron ore prices, which is not being highlighted at all. One is shortage, second side iron ore prices are going up. Internationally also, the steel prices, which we have seen $397 FOB in China, today it is over $600.
Oh.
So more than 50% increase in steel prices globally. So increase in iron ore price and shortage are the main reasons why we are also seeing increase in steel prices globally. So India is not different. India is following exactly what is happening globally. But the price increase in India relative to what happened, more than 50% increase in steel prices from its lowest level globally. India steel prices have not gone up to that extent.
Okay.
Still it is at a discount as far as India is concerned.
Okay. Mr. Rao, lest we run out of time and we have to get to the RBI governor, I must ask you this. Have you all upped the price that you are offering for Bhushan Power and Steel? And if yes, how much?
No, there are so many speculative reports talking about Bhushan Power and Steel. Sometimes they say JSW Steel is not interested, they are withdrawing, they're renegotiating for the price. Whereas today's report says that we have improved the offer. But it is very unfortunate BPSL resolution is getting delayed. We are eagerly waiting for the resolution. We understand the Supreme Court hearing is posted for 13th of January 2021. So we are eagerly waiting for that to complete it. We are very much committed to the BPSL resolution plan. Unfortunately, IBC doesn't provide for any option to the resolution applicant to do anything other than continue with the resolution plan until it is decided by the courts. So we are waiting very eagerly. We are constantly in touch with the COC to find some solution to implement the plan as early as possible.
Okay, so that's on Bhushan Power. Mr. Rao, just to go back to the factors you explained on pricing, it appeared to me that this big price rise is more because of supply side constraints and the cost push factor. What about demand? Is that really visibly improving or not?
Demand side in April, as you all know, there is a 91% fall in demand. The same number, if I compare in November, it is -2%. So therefore, more or less, the demand is at the last year levels in the segments. But if I look at sector by sector, the infrastructure, large infrastructure projects, construction, real estates, they've all recommenced the work. That is why TMT rebars are concerned. There is a very good recovery in the demand. Over and above that, we are also seeing recovery in the auto sector, plus consumer durables, white goods, roofing, plus bearings by railways and windmills. So there is a good recovery as far as the demand is concerned. I think it is not true that there is a shortage of steel because demand is not there. Demand one side is recovering. Because of iron ore shortage, the production is not able to keep pace with the improvement in demand.
Mr. Rao, just to come back to Bhushan Steel, you can, if 90% of the creditors agree, pull it out of IBC altogether and offer a better term. Are you thinking of offering better terms at all? Are you thinking of other ways of resolving it?
As far as Bhushan Power and Steel is concerned, we have committed to the resolution plan. There is no provision where we can exit or we will 90% agree or otherwise. We are very much committed to Bhushan Power and Steel, but the issue is relating to the litigations which are going on in Supreme Court. So we are eagerly waiting for the Supreme Court to take up the case and then decide it or adjudicate on that. As far as the implementation of the resolution plan is concerned, the COC has committed in the Supreme Court on 6th of March 2020 that in case the resolution applicant goes ahead with the implementation of the resolution plan, and if there is any adverse judgment by Supreme Court subsequently, then in that event, they will refund the amount that is paid by the resolution applicant.
Okay.
Therefore, we are negotiating with the COC how they will refund the money to us in case we go ahead and implement the resolution plan. Other than that, I don't think there is any other speculative news I would like to comment upon.
Not that you have upped the price.
It is not that it is upping the price. We are in constant touch with the COC to find a solution how we will be able to implement the resolution plan, protecting all the downside from outside.
Okay. Okay. So, I mean, are you offering easier terms in that case?
See, there the issue today is where there is a commitment by COC in the Supreme Court that they will refund the money in the case of adverse judgment. Therefore, how to find a solution, how the money will be refunded, or how the
Got that,
resolution
yeah.
plan, how the resolution plan can be unwound in case of adverse judgment. That is where I think the negotiations are going on.
All right. Okay, sir. Thank you very much for patiently answering so many questions and for explaining the steel backdrop as well. Thank you very much for joining us. It's an important day. We are celebrating our 21st anniversary for CNBC TV 18, and you're part of that celebration. Thanks a lot.
Many, many happy returns of the day. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Okay, we have to take a quick break, and we are going to thank our colleagues Surabhi and Sonia as well. After this, we are getting into our monetary policy special. The policy will be announced at 10 a.m. and we have a galaxy of bankers and experts joining us. A.K. Goyal of UCO Bank, Anant Narayan, the Professor of Finance, Taimur Beg, Managing Director and Chief Economist at DBS Group, Kaushik Das, Chief Economist at Deutsche Bank, and a whole host of others. Back in a jiffy.